Today we'll talk about the ineligible for enhanced listings error in the merchant center. This error can lead to the product disapprovals and even the entire feed suspension. We cover five things: enhanced free listings requirements checklist, common account level issues affecting enhanced eligibility, common item level issues affecting enhanced eligibility, resolving ineligible for enhanced listing issues, and the best way to contact Google. We'll start with enhanced free listings requirements checklist. To be eligible for enhanced listings, which show your products in content-rich listings, you want to ensure that you have fulfilled all the requirements that Google has created, including verified and claimed website, feed, all the required product data, shipping setup in the merchant center or in your feed, tax setup in the merchant center or in your feed, and compliance with all policies for free listings, shopping ads, and website policies. There are quite a few requirements, and the reason for all this elevated requirement is that Google wants to provide high quality user experience for all shoppers that are viewing your listings. This was enhanced free listings requirement checklist. Now let's look at common account level issues affecting enhanced eligibility. Enhanced eligibility issues can be at the item level or the account level. Because account level issues apply to the entire account and all associated products, start with account issues first. Visit the account issues tab in diagnostics to see if you received a warning indicating that your account is ineligible for enhanced listings. The most common site policy issues affecting enhanced eligibility are related to site policies, and sometimes you see these categorized as misrepresentation. Google has created all these requirements so that shoppers can easily discover critical seller information from your website to create quality user experience. Common issues I see are missing return and refund policy, insufficient contact information, insufficient payment info, incomplete checkout process, checkout unsecure, and destination URL down. Most of those settings can be found in the Tools Free Settings Setup tab of the Merchant Center. If you already ensured compliance with these guidelines, another reason your account might be ineligible for enhanced listings is because Google does not have sufficient signals to enroll your account. This may change over time, but in the meantime, your products will remain eligible for free standard listings. However, in this case, you can influence your eligibility by providing Google with high-quality info that ensures customers will have a positive experience. For example, you can link your Merchant Center account with a third-party platform such as Shopify or PayPal. Or if your platform isn't yet supported, you can opt in to Google Customer Reviews, a free program found in the Merchant Center. This was common account level issues affecting enhanced eligibility. Now let's look at the common item related issues affecting enhanced eligibility. Once you address the account level issues, head to the Item Issues tab in the Google Merchant Center Diagnostics. Set destination filter to free listings and set type of listings filter to enhanced listings. Here you can click on view examples or hover over the question mark to learn more about the issues you'd like to resolve. Some of the most common item level issues affecting enhanced eligibility are JTIN. This is the number one reason that a product is not eligible for enhanced listings. And this issue is often due to the lack of inclusion and consistent use of unique product identifiers such as JTIN, brand, and MPN. I've made a video about fixing identifier-related issues. You will find the link in the description or above in this video. Images. Common blockers include overlays, non-white backgrounds, or image being too small. Again, I've made a separate video about this. Check the description for a link or check above this video. Price mismatch and availability mismatch. This happens when the product price or availability in your feed does not match the price on your store. For this, you can consider turning on automatic item updates that can help you automatically update your products. Missing shipping value. That means you don't have the shipping set up for those products. go to the Merchant Center to set up your shipping settings, or you can also do that within the feed. And finally, missing required product attributes. For the enhanced listings, you need to provide all required attributes mentioned earlier. There are about 20 attributes. This was common level issues affecting enhanced eligibility. Now let's look at resolving enhanced listing related issues. To start resolving enhanced listing related issues, first isolate them in the product diagnostics tab of the Merchant Center. To do that, filter the destination by free listings and the type of listings by enhanced listings. Here you see all the issues for enhanced listings. The next is to understand the issues and hopefully fix them in the feed. Let's read the issue. So the first one, limited performance due to missing value JTIN, seems to be quite straightforward. Sometimes when the issue is not clear, hover over the question mark to get some additional information or even links to the help articles. So here Google helpfully tells you to add your product globally valid JTIN. Next step is to find those JTINs, add to the item IDs. To get the item IDs, you either download the list here or click on View Examples and get the item IDs from the view. You can also get additional information by hovering on the Information tab, and here you can get ID and also see the extent of the issue. So issue is limited to free listings. It affects only free listings. Once you get JTINs and update your feed, the next step is to resubmit the feed by either waiting until Content API does it automatically or by refetching the feed manually. 5-10 minutes after that, check the diagnostics and see if the issue went away and the number of affected items has decreased. This is how to resolve enhanced listing-related issues. If that doesn't work, you need to contact Google. And there are several ways to do that. Let's talk about that. The two ways I know of contacting Google in real time are calls and chats. To do calls, you need to find the phone number for your country. Search in Google for Google Ads phone number Canada or Google Ads phone number US or Google Ads phone number UK. Then you find these pages. This is pages for US. Here's a number. This page is for Canada, another number. And this page is for UK with some additional information. To contact Google via chat, you need to click on a question mark from inside your Merchant Center account or Google Ads account. Click, select Help Center and Support, Contact Us. You need to fill the minimum required information like enhanced listing issue, next step, confirm that. Then you need to enter your Google Ads account at this point. Next step. Okay, here you have options. Get a call, chat, or email. So to get a call and email means that you will get a call back or you will receive email back. But we click on chat, and after filling business information, you will be put onto the queue for the chats. And usually it's quite fast, like between 2 and 10 minutes. I've seen specialists on the chat support fix the issues quite quickly, and they can be quite helpful. Today I've looked at the ineligible for enhanced listings error. If you found this valuable, like this video so YouTube algorithm will show it more often to the people who are searching for this information. And as always, write in the comments about what other Google Ads related topics you want me to cover in my new videos. Thank you and have a great day.